I had only assembled all of the Earthlings for a celebratory cave bear hunt when we encountered the mountain dragon, Lignapaste, in the forest. Wow. Legend had it, it was invulnerable. My wolf, however, snuck over to the sleeping giant to investigate.
Oh. That dragon? His wolf? It's a wolf. Okay. Before I head to yonder dragon, let me look behind this tree, see if there's any message. I'm sure I must have missed some message. Okay. So if this were any other game, this would be a part where we die horribly, but I'm not sure if this is going to happen here. I'm ready to use Unrelenting Force on the thing. Oh! Hello? What does that mean? Was that a chapter? Did we get to a new chapter? Oh, am I stepping on twigs? Or am I supposed to sneak up on it? Well, these are twigs. And I'm back over here. Okay, avoid the twigs. Ah! You're kidding me. I didn't see a twig right there. That maybe? There's no twig in front of me. Oh.
And it vanished, as if struck by magic. The men roared with laughter again.
Really?
Still, Dryokta howled as if something was horribly amiss, yet the men would not give heed to her elegy and charged at the bear cave, as men do. The air, though, felt as if it had been corrupted by something sinister.
Am I supposed to be fighting this wolf? This wolf with a really strange name. Let's look behind this tree. That was pretty interesting, I gotta say. Nope. Nothing. Nothing, honey. At least now I can walk without worrying about stepping on twigs. That part was pretty interesting. Is it... Are those just trees? Those aren't just trees. I thought it was something standing there. Something big. I don't know if you guys can even see it. Okay, obviously you have to go that way. Let's go look out by the water, though. Maybe I could travel along the water line. Oh, I can't really get that close to the water. Okay. Well, it sure is pretty, though. Hey, blinding! Okay. I wonder what we'll find next. Oh, what's this up here? Oh, just more rocks? I thought it was like a stone, like, fort or something. Guess we're going this way. So is the dragon real, I wonder, or an illusion? Because it did just disappear. Now they're talking about a bear cave. They ran into a bear cave. What would a dragon have to do with a bear cave? Dragons are much bigger than bears. This looks very familiar to where I actually was, where I tried to move across, doesn't it? Doesn't it look like the area I tried to jump across and couldn't? Well, I got a whole lot of woods and stuff out here, I'll tell you that much.
Four berserkers aimed their arrows at something in the blackness.
Berserkers.
The leader drew the captured Cleave Salish. I had bestowed upon him and ventured forth with valor. Soon a cry from him was read. When my faction arrived, we witnessed them. Two werewolves, who had massacred the cave bears and devoured them like cats versus mice.
Wow.
Nevertheless, a light in their eyes persuaded me they had protected their human acumen. Hope, drowned in sorrow. All of a sudden, Dryokta gifted them a small number of novel flowers, and thus they were remade as men once again.
So the wolf gave them flowers. And that renewed their hope? That's pretty nice for a wolf. Most wolves don't give out flowers, much less renew people's hope. So, what else? So if this reminds anyone of Dear Esther, it's obviously inspired, at least in a roundabout way. 777 steps left to finish the game. Well, you just broke immersion. I broke immersion talking about Dear Esther. So how many steps have I taken? Am I halfway there? Must have taken hundreds of steps by now. Can I climb this? Must climb. No. Where's this wolf? I want to find this wolf, this Dryokta wolf, or whatever the hell the name is. That almost looks like a man-made wall. This is a rather big tree. Let's see. Nothing. Oh! There's another like castle fort type thing over there. Alright, looks like we end over here. It's like a dead end, but I want to check behind the tree, of course. Must find all the messages. For all I know, I missed a couple. I passed a few big trees before I even realized that something was written on one of them. Nothing. Is this something? Those trees look unusual. Yeah, look at those branches. Got twisty little gnarled hand branches. I guess I don't have anything to say about those. I want to go exploring that.
The transformed villagers looked around in a craze for a few minutes, puzzled and momentarily distorted. Once they realized they were human again, they embraced each other as if they had made it to Anwin itself. They were a bit abashed by Drakta though, and I did not understand that. It's perfectly sensible to be afraid of the dark, but light, typical of whites to be misread merit.
What's a white? The wolf is a white? Well, those men are whites. Maybe they're from the Isle of Wight. Well, I like this theme. Pretty. It's got that adventure sound to it. It reminds me of EverQuest back in the days of old. Jump across! Nope. Oh, I can almost get up there. Look at that. Through here. I haven't found anything interesting for a while. Oh, on a rock. There's no hiding from you. I guess not. So it's not only trees. Oh, there's another statue to interact with. Adventure theme. Hello there. Look very much like the other statue. Dagda, a high priest, went to war with a harp that could the seasons restore, yet it was stolen by a rival tribe and brought to a castle with vile vibe. Dagda chased his disputants and hailed his harp. It showed, and he struck it sharp, letting it sing the music of sleep, granting him flight to the forest deep. I like that. Another one of these log bridges. I'm not going back, am I? That'd be funny if it just suddenly transported us without knowing we're heading back to where we were. I'm hoping not, because I want to see new things, not the same old stuff. Now, this looks new up here.
Normally men are cursed to roam as foul miscreations of divine punishment because they need to atone for their wickedness. But
they
these
are?
Men were certainly as respectable as Gofanon himself, who crafted my silver hand after my initial was sliced off by the dragons I imprisoned beneath Gwyneth. They stated that there had once been farm in the land, and that was the only thing they relived. They didn't know how they got to be in this place, let alone who or what brought them here. But in my heart, I had a feeling.
Love the accent. You had a feeling. What'd you have a feeling about? Like, what was the feeling? What was the Hello? Reloading. You had a feeling about something. Oh! Well, this is different. Oh. Ooh, pretty. Aurora Borealis. That is a super, super moon. And it's moving. As you can probably tell. No. It's not moving. The stars are moving. It's remaining the same place above the mountains there. It's the stars that are moving. If I head back this way, will it load again? What's with all these, like, slate rocks? Oh, I literally can't go this way. Interesting. I like testing the boundaries of games. Okay, so I guess we can maybe interact with this fire here? Oh, and there's a tent. Oops. Whoops, I got stuck on ropes. Hello, Fiwa. No, I cannot interact with you, nor the pot over it. Wow. Who knew the flowers could also be lights? Maybe that's the symbolism of the wolf giving them the flowers, or flower.
The next week, Dryoxer summoned a dire precursor,
lights.
A demon by the name of Crom Cruach, and his band of werewolves.
Crom Cruach.
Falad were dishonoring a small village into human sacrifice as he wanted the magic possessed by my vats. I saw the blood of the innocent slither through the cracks of the land beneath them. I could not bear the sights of my own disciples butchered. Crom Cruach was one of the last diabolical forces left in my sphere, and if he and his underlings were not silenced, it could mean the end of these regions forevermore.
That would not be good. We don't want the end of the regions. Crom Cruach. Yeah, there's literally no word in English that actually uses a consonant sound like that. Ugh. I like it though. Wow, spooky. We're gonna meet this Crom Cruach.
As my normally thunderous bow of Gandiver would not be enough to exile this arch fiend, I turned to the druidess, Magruith, a master of theoranthropy.
What's that?
Who told me to wait for her by the river of Owen Reach at midnight, and so I did, with Dryoxer and my preferred paladins, under the aura of the stars and the stoicism of the moonlight. When I arrived, I eyed the most harrowing of scenes. Seemingly honest men, clenching black witch flowers to their hearts, and drinking from the waters which had emerged with the dark color of obsidian.
Obsidian, you mean? Alright, so those are not flowers of hope. So flowers of despair. We like these flowers. You can use them as flashlights. Oh, here's another statue. Hail. A young girl loved by every native while tending her herds of sheep, yet was dogged by eyes dated. An old man who would in the bushes weep. A farmer spotted a wolf in the moonlight. He shot at it with his bow. Behind the barn, the victim of the night, the old man lifeless, but smiling, even so. Okay. Yeah, this kind of looks like a sad area, doesn't it? Oh. Okay. That was a little alarming. What's around here? Dead end? Oh! Another message. Please don't take my screenshot. Frowny face. This belongs in the game, how? So we've got a shy rock wall or whatever. Ooh, what's this? Is that a waterfall way up there? Any more message? Keep forgetting, trying to hit the side arrows and those don't work. Oh, neat. Okay.
I covered a crank to lower this bridge.
Oh. Can't just say you want a crank. Okay, where's the crank? It's pretty dark. Alright, so I'm gonna find a crank. Hopefully I can see it. So there's a small amount of interactivity. I covered the crank to lower this bridge. I covered it. Thou shalt not covet. Where the hell would it be? I got up there, baby, before. I can do it again, damn you. Thank you. Can't zoom in. I wish I could. A crank. What's this? Nope. That's part of the rock. How far should I go looking for this crank? Let me check down here again. If I were a crank in the middle of rocks and stuff, where would I hide? Oh, I drifted off. How'd I do it? Okay, I'm multiple jumping here. I'm literally... Okay. I can see the message from here. I guess I can't do this one. Wait. Oh, so close. What if the crank... Is it... Don't! No!
Mm-hmm.
There you go. I can literally actually, it's funny because I can actually, didn't realize it, I can actually jump again before I land if I time it just right. Well, somehow I fall right off of that. That doesn't look like it should happen. See that? I'm jumping again before I hit the ground. I have to have that forward momentum to do it though, I think. Looking for a crank. I just slide right off that. Okay. Crank. I don't know where it is, obviously. It's just... It's dark. You feel like it would be easier to miss, right? I can see how it would be easy to miss as a crank of wonder. Okay, I was already up there anyway. No way I can climb that thing. Crank of wonder!
I wonder why this was dethroned.
Dethroned?
Or is this just a chimera? I cannot seem to animate this anamnesis.
What? Animate the anamnesis, what? Sweet.
Splendid. So, where are you, Dryactor? What transpired here at this forsaken site?
Are we gonna find the wolf? Yo, Wolfie! Dryactor, doggy. Wait, we got it here? I just find that funny.
Mark soon appeared with our ancient incarnations, seeking to banish the twilight and hail the sun, thereby stopping the warped pietism. But alas, she was not the only one there. Crom Cruach and the Banshee goddess, Cleodha, broke Mug's glamour and my saintly endowment with their primordial force, and with one rapid hex, the Banshee sent Mug flying into the dark waters, and thus, she was lost. Blackguards, may the gates of Tirnanu never open to you. The werewolves were too many for my soldiers and Dryoxer and her flowers, so we fled.
Who's Mug? I'm literally too tall to walk in there. How tall am I? Oh, is this just a really... a home of a really short person? Dryactor, or whatever, however you say it. Scooby-Doo, where are you? Sounds like all hope is lost kind of music. The time of despair is upon us. Tread lightly, my friends. There are demons afoot.